Yeah. Back at it again. Back at it again. Back at it again.
What's up, guys? So, just in case, just to clear things up, just in case you guys are wondering, he wore this in the last video. I'm doing two videos all in one, so I can stay ahead for YouTube. Like I said, I want to start this year off right, so we got to do right. So this video right here, we basically going to be doing a fused panel. In this video, so all that stuff you see me get in the last video, hopefully you guys I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna do my fuse panel. Oh, we got that laid out, so give me 1 second. Okay, so basically in this new video I'm doing is gonna be basically a fuse panel. I'm gonna run a couple accessories off of here. As you can see, I have fog lights, I have fan, hazard, fuel pump. I might have two more on here, so I don't know what they're going to be yet, but I'll figure it out when I do it. A little panel strip, and I have the block that I did last video. I didn't really show y'all, but I got this in. All this stuff came from Amazon. So for the most part, this should be fairly easy. You know, I believe if I can do it, anybody can do this one. I mean, this one's more easier to me than the other one I just did the last video. So let me push ahead. This is what it's supposed to look like. Alright. This is how I really wanted it to come out to look like. Yes, I'm got like a little art in me, so excuse me. But I basically drew out how I wanted the wires and stuff to go from the last video. I didn't show y'all this, but I'm showing y'all this in this video. So basically, I had it already planned where it goes right here on the side, and all the wires run down to the back. I didn't draw it in this picture. I guess I got sleepy or whatever. But all the wires are going to run towards the back, right? And then you got wires that are running out front of the car. And then you got my fuse panel that we're going to be making in this video. It's going to be right there underneath the dashboard that I'm going to put it at. And it's going to run, you know, whatever accessories I needed to run. Well, not fuse panel. Like little fuses and all that. It's going to be located right here, right? I also brought a panel for my center console, which I'll show you guys in this video. This right here is my radio. These are going to be my, like, gauges and whatnot. Let me see if I bring this up. So, the gauge cluster that comes with this car, I don't think I'm going to be running this one. But I am looking at aftermarket. But it's another company that I would be putting down here in this little description what it is. And basically, I like their gauge cluster and how they do it. And I like the way how Teller Ray, if you watch his videos, how he set up for his gauge cluster for his car, the way he set it up for his Miata. So that's what I'm going for. That's how I'm setting it up too. Guys, other than that, this is just later on down the road for like the gauge cluster. So that's going to be like the little unit. That's my key. That's the steering, the little pedals, and how the wires are run. You won't see these wires because it's going to be basically tucked up beneath this panel. But I was just drawing that just to show you how many wires I'm trying to have run off of that. All right. So on this right here, we're going to probably put push start is going to be right there. What else? You're gonna have your key entry, your push start, and all these wires just for like ignition only and turn signals. So hopefully I can figure all that out within like the next video, and we can go about that. All right, guys. So I know this is not gonna be in this video, but I'm just kind of really, really happy for this little switch panel I got. And I brought this off of eBay. I think I paid like $29.99 or $35 off eBay. But basically, it's got Voltrus meter. You can hook like your little UPS cords or whatever if you want to charge your phone. And I also have a 12-volt constant like for cigarette lighters and all that. So just in case I want to run that in there. And these are my switch panels. So I'm really liking this, and it's already like pre-set up, so this should be like a straightforward thing. As you can see all of it's lined up. All you gotta do is add accessory wires of what you wanted to run off of. So when I want to run my fans, I just put it on one of these switches. And I also got little labelers to tell me, you know, little screws, my labels and all that. So this should be a fairly simple installment, but it's not going to be in this video. So be on the lookout for that. Fuse blocks, ABS for plastic, and that. Some wire connectors, snippet or crimpets. Case, I might need that. Oh, that's right, I forgot. And screws. That's all you're going to need, pretty much, for this. It's going to be a straightforward and whatnot, so let me show you how I'm going to set this up. Alright guys, so that's the way I was planning to run it. And I'm still probably going to run it like this. But I was looking at it from this angle. It kind of looks kind of cool. But I'm not going to need all these fuel blocks. I'm not going to need all this. I'm not going to need this. So what I'm going to do is run it just like this. Yep, run it just like that. That should be easy, because if I try to run it like this, right, there's only one problem, and that's starting all right over here from the end. That's to say, you gotta get that and see how that don't stretch all the way too clean. So still think I'm still gonna have a problem, because I see, let's see, 3 and 3. Yep, I'll be able to run all that. Okay, so yeah, that's how I'm gonna run it. I'm gonna run it just like this, and yeah, just hammer it down and just run it just like that. So what I gotta do now is I'm gonna mark a couple of holes on here, so I know where I'm drilling, at and whatnot. And that should put me at a more ease mind frame, if that makes any sense to you guys. Cause right now, you know, you can do this all day and still kinda mess up. And I don't really wanna mess up on this ABS. I don't want to mess up on this plastic. I feel like I should have used this right here, this plastic, for the panel when I made it for the other fuse box, but no, I didn't do that. So this right here is my power. This right here is my ground. And I have to see what other direction, make sure this is not going to be another constant power or something there. Because I read up that some of these got it, like where you gotta make that a constant ground or something like that. I don't know. I'm just, like I said, I'm just learning about all this, so I'm new. See what I mean? I'm off. Off by hair. It's okay though. We can fix that right now. Alright guys, so as you can see, like, that's real long in the back, but should be alright. I don't think I'm gonna have a flush rush against it, but it should be good enough. Alright, so this is what we're gonna do. I figured out these right here are constant power. The red is, the black is coarse ground, and then we got the blue. Blue and white are gonna be like in and out power. And that should be really simple for what we need to be done for this whole panel. So let's get started. I'm gonna start with the red. I'm gonna pull all this back. Alright guys, so now I'm going to use my crimpers. I just want to make sure that's the only crimpers I got. I think I might have some more. Let me see. No, I think these are the only style I do have. Hopefully these things fit, because I didn't order any crimpers or get any more for any case maybe. I found some crimpers, so what I'm going to do is take it and slide it up on here and work my magic. If I run out of them for them crimpers, I should have enough to do for this side. I did not think about getting them. So I had to remove a fuse box because I messed up on one, as you can see. So I just removed that out. If I need some more, I just order some more from Amazon. But so you basically got to cut them down to your trim. Like right now, that's too long, so I'm probably going to cut about right there. And then once I cut it right there, then that should be good. You don't have to do it like this. I'm just choosing to. You can basically just crimp that in, just cut it, crimp it, and leave it like it is. But that's pretty much what I'm doing. So I'm not gonna bore you guys anymore. I'm just gonna cut it back on when I get down with that process. So I'm just gonna basically do this, do the hot side first, and then I'll turn it back on for the ground. Okay, so I ran my, my first set of wires like that. Now I'm about to get ready to do this terminal. So it's basically going to be blue, white, blue, white, blue, white, blue, white. And that should be good for that. So let me see something. Yeah. We might have another little problem. As you can see, it's already up there. God, I didn't think about this when I did it. You know what? What I could do? Add the other terminal up here, guys. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna add the other terminal up here. I might not use all of it, but I can use half of it. So, Yeah, it worked out good then. Okay. All right, guys. So I wired up one side, did one side for this side, and did the other side for the other terminals. So that should be good now. Now I just got to put my grounds on, and that's the end of, that's it. All right, guys. So here goes my last update. So I connected everything, but I short one connector. So I'm just going to buy a little pack of connectors and call it a day. But other than that, that's the series of the wiring. Hopefully you like this video. Like, comment, subscribe, you know, all that good stuff, guys. Take care. And don't forget to watch the last video. And if you have any questions, just hit me up. Just hit me up on this. This I'm good with, but the other stuff that I've been doing, it's been a little hard. So stay tuned for the next video where we start doing some more wiring for the Nissan 240. As soon as I get everything wired up and wire loom and all that good stuff, we should be good to go. So, like I said, give my video a thumbs up, y'all. I need that support. Need that support. I'm pushing out content for you guys. You want content? You want this to be done? I want to be driving this by this year, which we should be, because everything's looking on the up and up. So, yeah. Stay tuned, guys. Peace.
You know we had to go shopping one more time, right? I think we forgot something. Y'all know me, cause all I do is ride around a bit cool. Y'all know me, cause all I do is ride around a bit cool. Y'all know me, cause all I do, y'all know me, cause all I do, y'all know me, y'all know me, y'all know me, y'all know me.